James, Metropolis of Missouri, we go to James. It's not now. To work in grace. I come by the grace of the Christian come as we give to work in James. But as present. But here in our high five, I'll give you my hand out of sour. Look on that, it can be poor. We know how to show the way of grace. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Let's sit down in the presence of the Lord. Thanks to see all of you. Hallelujah. As I said last Sunday, I'm still trying to see where you are. In the tent, I picked some of you, but now I'm wondering where you are. I also know you are also looking at the place you can see me well.
Yes.
We bless the name of the Lord. If you are visiting us for the very first time, we want to welcome you to this place, the house of our Father. If you lift up your hand, we'll support you quickly. We'll see you where you are, and we want to welcome you. Whether you are up there or down here, the Lord bless you. Anybody up there? Oh, there is something up there. There's another one up there. Let's appreciate them properly. One, two, three. Amen. Jesus loves you and me and all of us. The Lord bless you. Thank you for making a choice to worship with us. After the service, there is a place prepared for you. Please join us there.
Hallelujah.
People are going to America. Rachel is going to Boston. Not Boston. Baltimore, Portugal, Florida. Let me try to be an American. Baltimore. Is that a Baltimore? And a million. And Baltimore. He's going to Baltimore. And I asked the leader, please, you want to say something? Or my group of microphone? Pass, Emma.
Pass.
Even now in the U.S. you bless them. Because there is no nation tanta quelle stanno, quanta has been blessed of God. That is what you told the Balak. That there is no way that God can cast that which he has already blessed. We pray for Bogwa and his children and the grandchildren that Lord God Almighty, you will keep him well and your grace will be sufficient for him. For this we ask in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Let your go well. We also need your anointing. So that when you go to the embassy, I want to release a maswali. Blessed be the name of God. I want to ask my friend Professor Kiriko. He's also going to the U.S. But he himself and Lucy, they are going for medical. If it all goes well, they will get out before Friday, because he has an appointment with the doctor on Friday. He had an operation with one of his eyes. It needs to be rectified, and he needs also an operation on the other eye. However, kwa sababu kuna mambo, kuna mambo ya kuna mambo mengine inatetekana, inaitwa emergency. Emergency, I spoke with the professor on the 20th, with the Lucid, and we agreed, we started running. And it is going very fast. But we need you to get there as fast as we can. If I had my private jet, you know the problem of speaking to some people that things sometimes take so long for it to come up. Now get my boy Gilwan on a shanga, private jet to the park walking. Don't worry where you're parking. Because there are people who have them. I don't. Wherever they park, say that means a park yango pale. If I had one, the worker should be like a mafuta. Charging a lot of mafuta. So that he can go with me. But because I don't have,
because of our hand,
to work a mafuta, your jetty go pale airport. But I saw security. So in the afternoon at 2 o'clock, we'll meet in the tent of meeting, so that we can help him. At least so that he can go this week. Look at your neighbor. And remember, I quite easy. Actually, it is not easy. I know some of us, we get to a situation like this, and you don't know what to do. It's not easy. So in the afternoon, let's come and stand with them. Whatever gift we have. Now look at your neighbor. Tell them on my behalf. Where? Bishop anakujua. Anakujaga Jumapili tu. Ande ukuji. Wednesday ukuji. Na ukiambiwa hivyo unasema ni kweli. Kwanza wengine mnajua mkitoka hapa mnakojwa na watu wengine. Kwa sababu ya hiyo, Bwana awabariki. Utaweka chombo hapa. Kumaliza ibada hii kwa sababu hakuna nyingine. Utakuja wewe uweke chupa yako hapa. Utampatia pesa. Sasa. Tuliulize kwa sababu ya Yesu kwa kweli. Hautakuja tena uulize. Hautakuja tena.
Professor,
Heavenly Father, we pray for our brother, Professor Kiritu. We also pray for
Lucy.
Ask dear Lord, may come to us in their venerable moments. Help us to cover them. Help us to protect them. And help us to be a blessing to them. We also pray for your favor. As they go for their visas, we pray for your favor. As they receive the connection flights, and as they get to the U.S., may your favor be with them. May the doctors treat them well because of the grace of the Lord. And whoever will bless them, because they are the sons and daughters of Abraham, may they receive the blessings of Abraham in the mighty name of Jesus. And may every giver that will give today, at their time of need, may they never lack someone to give them in the mighty name of Jesus. We thank you, Lord, and we give you praise. In Jesus' name. Amen. Hallelujah. Did I welcome the visitors? I also prayed for Rachel. And I prayed for Professor. Now this is the day that the Lord has made. Tell your neighbor this is it. Because God has a word for you. And God has prepared a vest for you. And today is a great day. The speaker is triple K. The interpreter is double K. Let's all arise and welcome Karoba, Kamau, Kiroko, and the interpreter Kamau, Kiroko.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Bwana asifiwe. Praise the Lord.
Bwana asifiwe.
Brethren, I am overwhelmed by the goodness of the Lord. Because of his doing in my life and even in your life, you may sit down. For those that do not, we have not met or interacted, probably you were born after I left for the United States. I want to introduce myself. My name is Karoba Kamau Kiroko. And all those are Christian names. And what you can see is a Christian brother. And I love the Lord Jesus Christ as my personal Savior. I am from here, and where I'm here, I am home. I left here in 1998 together with my wife and children, and we went to the United States of America. And our going to America was not easy. It was a testimony of the hand of God. And let me tell you, friends, if you have a dream and the Lord gives it to you, be persistent and be resilient. Don't be scared by the anybody who says it cannot be done. Myself, as I stand before you, I was given my visa the fifth time. Because when I said I was going, and I took my passports, five of them, to the American Embassy. And I put those passports, five of them, through that small window. The lady behind me there Esther looked at them and said, what's all this? And I said, these are my passports and my family. What do you want with them? I said, I want visas, I'm going to America. Before then, I had not known anybody who had been denied a visa. I was living in a world where everything was possible. And so I was told, no, they were all starting to deny, deny, deny. And as I received them back, I said, who is right? Is it the voice I heard or these people here? And I decided, no. I had already told people, I am going on this particular day. I had already thrown a party. My daughter Rosemary had already thrown a party in her school at Kwaraka Academy. Myself, I'm going to America. We are going to America. And my dad said, next week we will be on our way to America. And then I denied the visa. And my faith is that on the line now. So then I went back. I came back and they said, you don't have enough reasons to show that you are coming back. And you know, I was going to come back. That's why I'm here today. And so I looked around and I said, no, I'm going again. I presented the papers again. And the second time, denied, denied, denied. But I knew God. That when God says yes, nobody can say no. And the last time again, no. And by this time, the school I was going to, they have already opened and the tap is already going. After the fourth time, I decided, no, let me go back and inquire from the Lord. If you knew how to pray and to fast, this is the time. So we went to Katoroni, me and Elishima. And we prayed and we stayed there for 3 days. And when we stayed there, the Lord told us, He has given us America. So we are still possessing it even now. So when I presented the papers again, the Lord graced the occasion. And together with me was a man who had said, you know what, Pastor? It is good to know when the Lord is saying no. Because the Lord has confirmed that you're not going to America. And He ensured that that man was there. So finally, I was told by the consular, now we know. And we understand now you are going to America. We give you your visa. You can come for the rest in the afternoon or tomorrow for your family. And that is the God I came to tell you this. That our God is a faithful God. That when He says yes, no authority on earth can say no. When the Lord says yes, it is yes, and it is amen in Christ Jesus. If you are sick and the Lord tells you, I am the Lord your healer and I am going to heal you. My wife and my children and my grandchildren. Because I'm a young man of a few years. And the Lord has blessed us, me and my wife, with three children. Rosemary.
It's
a high school teacher in the US. And then we have our son, Samuel Kiroko. Who is a medical practitioner in California. Then we have our baby son,
Daniel.
Who is a civil engineer in Canada. Rosemary is married. And they have given us two young men, grandchildren, Noah and Jude. So as you see me, I'm born three times now. And Sam is still believing God for a wife. And as I look around, I'm saying, who is Sam? For what I can see. But I believe when he comes, he will see for himself. So continue to pray for him. And then we have Daniel. Daniel is married. And they live with his wife in Canada. Today, I bring you greetings also from the church. They are praying for us, even as they pray for me. Let's say, tell your neighbor, this is the day the Lord has made. And I will rejoice and be glad in it. Let me remind you that today is the greatest gift that you have in your
hands.
Because the main business of life is to make the most of today. No wonder the psalmist says in Psalms 118 and verse 24. This is the day the Lord has made. I will rejoice and be glad in it. And therefore you must have intention. And you must purpose in yourself to make the most out of today. And today I want to speak to people who find themselves in the prisons of the past. Probably you have gone through tragedies. Probably you have gone misjudgments. You have made judgments that have impacted your life and you feel like you are stuck somewhere in the past. There are only issues that came in the course of your life. But then you find you are always tired and pulled down by the memories of the past. Because sometimes the past can be a big liability in your life. It can be something that is always draining your talent. You are not enjoying life to the fullest because of the memories of the past. It is always dragging you down. The past should not be a liability, but it should be an asset. Something you look back and say, I learned the lesson. Your future. You are losing your time. When you deal with the past intentionally, you tell God to move past your circumstances. Because the past is past and God is it. You cannot change your past, but you can control your today. You can decide to take action. You can decide to move on. You cannot raise those people that have died in your family. But you can decide to give life to those that are already with you. I am reminded a few years ago, probably about 50 years ago, when my grandmother died. And I remember the place I was in. Because that time we used to live in villages. We used to live in villages, and I remember the truck that I was there, the path that I was on. And I asked God, is it one of the members of my family who be dying? And every time I remember that question, I remember the tragedies of naivety. When you cannot see beyond where you are. Let me tell you, friends, that misfortunes come and tragedies come to everybody. But we have the Lord God Almighty, who says today is your day. Today is the day of salvation. Today is your day of deliverance. Today is your day of restoration. And you don't have to live in the past. Because God is with you. The past is gone. You cannot change it. But the future, the present is in your hands. So that you can direct your energy to your future. I know your life, like mine, is filled with good and bad experiences. Success and failure. Pain and pressure. But you don't have to be brought down to the experiences of the past. Because God has a better future for you. He says, I have good plans for you. All is to give you a future and a hope. That is all. But before he does that, he needs you to partner with him. Because we waste valuable time regretting the past and fretting the future. But today, I want to appeal to you, brethren, that you need to make the most of the moment. Some things you cannot go over them. If you have lost a spouse, if you have lost a child, if you have lost an exam, if you have lost a business, probably there is nothing you can do about the losses that you make. You need to forget it. In the book of Philippians chapter 3, I want us to read it. From 13 and 14. Brethren, this is Brother Paul talking to the Philippian church. And he tells them, brethren, I do not count myself to have apprehended. Forward towards those things. that Jesus.
Yeah.
But let me tell you, friends, life is a competition. Life is a competition. Today you might be sailing very softly. And you are gliding through the moment. But let me tell you, friends, the kingdom of God is as violence. And only the violent take it and take it by force. When they are opening their business at 7 o'clock, open yours at 6 o'clock. When they are getting their goods, some blessings, Zimmerman.
And then he asked me, Pastor, how much money do you need?
And then I took him the figure. And then he asked me, do you need it in check or in cash? Just because of that single move that I did. Sometimes we hide ourselves in spirituality and fail to deal with the real issues. Brethren, the Lord wants us to take a move. The Lord wants us to move forward. Because he's saying, don't cry anymore. I have had your cry. I want to move, but I want to move with you. God cannot move alone. God wants to move with you and do great things for your life. You have done it in the past. You have accomplished it in the past. But that is only a museum. Now you need to do something today. You need to do something today. And the thanks be to God that we have an example. The Lord Jesus Christ. In Hebrews 12, verse 1 and 2. The Bible talks about some baggage that we need to leave behind. In order for us to focus, he says, looking unto Jesus, the author and the finisher of our faith. That means he is laying aside every baggage. Sometimes your success and your accomplishments can be the greatest impediments success. But the Bible says, leave them behind. Move on. And let God be your partner. Because today is your day. Number two, forget the analysis of the past. You will begin to remember the melons that you ate in Egypt. When I left to America, melons were only watermelons were only available for a very selected group of people. It is not like today when you can buy a watermelon out there. Those things are so good, particularly in a dry climate, that they make the children of Israel almost for faith. The blessings of God, they actually made them miss the promises of God. Because when they remembered the watermelons, and then they remembered their graves, they were not willing to lay hold of the promises of God. I pray that none of us will be found wanting in that area. They started remembering those things. And then they
he understands this very well. But suffering in this fallen world is not a respecter of persons. The young suffer. The old suffer. The women suffer. The men suffer. And the children too. So suffering is not a respecter of persons. So the fact that you have suffered in the past, sprout deep in your heart. Probably your wife offended you or did something and it has been offending you for a long time. Or your husband. Or your mother or your father. And because you have been cutting them, everything you try, it is crashing down.
Today is your day.
the Lord for the things that he has done.
May the Lord bless you. May the Lord bless you.